Maybe we will proceed with the presentation, the next coming presentation of Dr. Fatmegyul Mustan-Borisova from the Faculty of Chemistry and Pharmacy of Sofia University. And she will share further with us molecular dynamic simulations of fenofibrata solubilization into bile salt and fatty acid micelles. So, please, Professor Mustan-Borisova.
Hello, everybody. Well, thank you for the introduction. I'll present a brief introduction about our study, and I'll define our aim of the study, and present the used computational protocol and the molecular models. And I'll explain the obtained results about the pure bile salt micelles, mixed micelles with fatty acids, and the solubilization of fenofibrate, and I'll finish with the main. So the bile salts are the polyhydroxysteroid acids with hydrophobic steroid parts illustrated here, and part containing two or three hydroxy groups and some hydrophilic tails, which can be conjugated by glycine or their main role is in the gastrointestinal tract of the human, and that is why it is important to see their aggregation behavior, because their aggregate can solubilize hydrophobic molecules from the in the gastrointestinal tract, and also some hydrophobic drugs. We know that the conventional surfactants, which are contained hydrophilic heads and hydrophobic long form spherical or cylindrical micelles or lamellar phases, depending on their concentration in the solutions. But due to the specific chemical structure of the bile salt, they form a more different micelles called primary and secondary micelles. The primary micelles are characterized with aggregation numbers below 10, and the main forces that stabilize them are the hydrophobic interactions, and by hydrogen bonding, the primary form secondary micelles with aggregation number above 10. They also can form some disc-like micelles or helical micelles at some specific conditions. So in the literature, there are a lot of experimental results for their aggregates, and it is found they are very small, and also some molecular dynamics simulations, but them are at very high concentration of bile salt. So, but their concentration in the gastrointestinal tract is very low. And that is why we decided to study their behavior at conditions close to the conditions in the gastrointestinal tract of the in the humans, as by monitoring the kinetics of aggregation of fixed bile salts and analyzed two intermolecular forces acting within the most stable aggregates, and also to define their shape and size. We used six different molecules, so folate and deoxycholate. Folate is the derivative with the three hydroxy groups. Deoxycholate is with two hydroxy groups in the hydrophilic head, and their glycine and taurine conjugated derivatives. So we used atomistic molecular dynamic simulations in canonical ensemble with force field amber for describing the bile salt molecules, and tip 3P for water molecules. So we placed random molecules in periodic box with sizes in three directions, 11 nanometers, and we ran production around 150 nanoseconds. As a first step, we analyzed the the aggregation process during the simulation. And here the maximum poster size as a function of the simulations presented for 3-hydroxy and 2-hydroxy derivatives. And here you can see that the process is hierarchical and it's fastest for taurodeoxycholate here, and the biggest aggregates are formed by glycine conjugated derivatives, and the conjugated and non-conjugated derivatives form stable pentamers. We compare the obtained aggregation with experimentally determined at similar conditions, and we found very good agreement with the experimental data. Molecules with 3-hydroxy groups in the hydrophilic part, but there is a big difference between our data and the experimental data about the aggregation for the deoxy derivatives. It is due to the fact that they observe formation of secondary micelles, and it is discussed that 3-hydroxy derivatives form stable primary micelles, deoxycholate, and but deoxy derivatives form secondary micelles. But in our case, we have only 8 molecules in the periodic box. Basically, we cannot observe formation of secondary micelles. So this is the illustration of these stable aggregates. Here you can, there is no orientational ordering of the molecules within the aggregates, and actually they are very dynamic, and they their position in the aggregate and it can allow them solubilize very easy some hydrophobic molecules in their vicinity. So we also studied the interactions between these molecules. We analyzed the number of contacts between the molecules here in these stable aggregates. Here the population of the number of minimum distances between the molecules in the stable aggregates are presented for the 3 and dehydroxy derivatives, and here you can see that these distances are very short, and here it means that no water molecules immersed inside the aggregates, and the area between the molecules is completely hydrophobic. It can from these pictures where the green parts are the hydrophobic parts, and the red ones are the of the molecules. From this study, from the first part of the study, we conclude small primary micelles are formed in all systems at low biosolids concentration with radius about 1 nanometer. We calculated it analyzing the radius of gyration, and also the shape for all of them are deformed, ellipsoid, or non-ordered. Also, aggregates are formed by glycine derivatives, while tauroconjugated and non-conjugated biosolids form stable pentamers. The driving forces for aggregation are hydrophobic interactions between the steric rings, and the core of the micelles are entirely hydrophobic and does not tolerate inclusion of water molecules. This fact and the fact that the their intensive dynamic of the molecules within the aggregates can explain their capacity to hydrophobic molecules. In our department, the experiment with taurodeoxycholate performed to study their solubilization capacity by using fenofibrate drug molecules, which is a hydrophobic molecule. And it is studied the solubilization of drug molecule in the solutions of only biosolids and the solutions of biosolids mixed with fatty acids. And here, amount of solubilized fenofibrate as a function of saturated fatty acid chain length is shown. And it can be seen that there is a maximum at C14. But when unsaturated fatty acids are used, solubilized fenofibrate increases significantly. Based on this experimental data, we defined our aims for the second part of the study to monitor the micelle formation of tau deoxycholates without and without added fatty acids, and try to determine the amount of the solubilized drug in the micelles. So we studied only tau deoxycholate as a biofault because the experiments are performed with tools and fenofibrate as a drug molecules. It is frequently encountered in lipid-based formulations development. As fatty acids, we studied myristate, stearate, and oleate. All of them are salt. So the used computational protocol is the same as the previous study, with this difference that in 100 molecules of tau deoxycholate, 100 molecules of fatty acids when they present, and 40 molecules of drug. The length of the production run in this case is 300 nanoseconds, and the periodic box is larger. This is the initial configuration of the system with only tau deoxycholate, water molecules, and the cation electrolytes. We constructed four different initial configurations in order to check the reproducibility relations in respect to the aggregation processes. And here the average cluster size and the maximum cluster size as a function of simulation. Four different simulations are presented, and here you can see that we have very good reproducibility in respect to the average size. And the reproducibility for the maximum cluster size is also acceptable. From these simulations, we determined the average cluster size after 300 nanoseconds because we have. The equilibrium state is reached, and we compared this cluster size with the experimental data, and we obtained very good agreement, and we can say that our protocol is very good to reproduce experimental behavior of these molecules. The next step was the addition of fatty acids. Here, the initial configuration of the system with myristate and oleate are shown. The fact that in the experiments, the fatty acids are added in the solution of tau deoxycholate where the micelles are formed already. That is why simulation, we tried to mimic the experimental procedure, and that is why the fatty acid molecules are randomly placed inside the solution. Tau deoxycholate micelles. Here, the average cluster size is a function of simulation time for the systems with myristate and oleate. The picture is similar with the stearate. In all cases, we have formation of micelles between tau deoxycholate and fatty acids, which is not clear from the experiment, actually. We can answer that yes, in the experiment we have mixed micelles which solubilize the drug. This table will summarize the data about the composition of all obtained aggregates. These are molecules in all formed aggregates in the systems, and here you can see that in case of fatty acids, we pure fatty acid aggregates in addition to the mixed aggregates. And in these mixed aggregates, the ratio between tau deoxycholate and fatty acids varies in a wide range, means that the content of these aggregates are very different. And it will be interesting to see in which aggregates the molecules of the drug will solubilize. So, and the next step was to add a drug molecule in these model systems. So, due to the fact that the fenofibrate is non-soluble, and in the experiment it is as a crystal in the solution of biosalts together with the fatty acids, and that is why we formed such aggregates from the fenofibrate and placed it randomly inside the periodic boxes with tau deoxycholate micelles and fatty acid molecules. Run on the 300 nanoseconds of simulations. In all cases, all the molecules in the initial aggregate of fenofibrate remain in the same aggregate. There is no separation of fenofibrate molecules from the gates, but there is some incorporation of basalt and fatty acid molecules in this, and this is the illustration after 300 nanoseconds of the simulations. Here you can see that in pure citric deoxycholate, the fenofibrate aggregate is surrounded from by the molecules of tau deoxycholate, but of the myristate and oleate, they are immersed between the fenofibrate molecules. And here there are tau deoxycholate molecules between the water medium and the aggregates, where oleate molecules are inside between the fenofibrate molecules. In case of stearate, it is a little bit different. In this case,